Hello, my dear children. Welcome back to social studies class. I'm sure you must be excited for this first video after your examination. You all must have scored very good marks. I'm so proud of you all. So without any ado, let's start. Chapter number 5, the Southern Plateaus and the Islands. Concept number 1. So children, before starting, let me discuss with you, which we have already discussed in the live class, what is a plateau? A flat area of land that is raised above its surrounding is called a plateau. It is elevated above the sea level. So children, let me tell you, the word plateau is a French word, which also means table land. And it is also used for some smaller landforms. Now children, plateau has a flat top and steep sides. Since it looks like a table, a plateau is also called a tableland. So now you know the answer. If I ask you the question, why plateau is also called a tableland, you can say, ma'am, because plateau has a flat top and steep sides like a table. Let's move further. Can you see this map of the Great Indian Peninsula Plateau, which has Deccan Plateau in the purple shaded part? Now let's see the plateau region. Children, let me tell you, River Narmada is the most important river of the plateau region. Why is it important? Because River Narmada roughly divides the plateau region into two parts. Number first is the Central Highlands, and number second is the Deccan Plateau. Now children, the Central Highlands lie towards the north side, okay, the northern side. Now the Deccan Plateau lies towards the southern side. Let's move further and let's see the map. On your left hand side, you have the map which includes the Central Highlands, which has Aravali Hill Ranges, Vindhya Hind Ranges, Chota Nagpur Plateau, all of these. And then finally, downwards, you can see that the Deccan Plateau map is also there, which is surrounded by Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. Okay. And these Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats meet at Nilgiri Hills. As you can see the meeting point in the map also. On the right hand side, we have already discussed that Narmada River is the river which divides the Southern Plateau region into two parts. Let's move further. This is the beautiful valley of the plateau region. And on the left hand side, you can see River Narmada. Now let's talk about the Central Highlands. The Central Highlands are surrounded by the Aravali Hill Range towards the northwest and the Vindhya Range towards the south, the Chota Nagpur Plateau towards the east, and the Raj Mahal Hill towards the northeast. Now children, I would like to tell you the meaning of the word surrounded, which we have already discussed in the live class. Surrounded means that it is covered from all the four sides. So the Malwa Plateau lies in the center of the Central Highlands. A number of rivers of the Central Highlands such as Chambal, Son. Please see the pronunciation of this word Son. It's not Sun, it's Son. And Betwa from the south join the rivers Ganga and Yamuna from the south. Now you have to understand children that Ganga and Yamuna river lies in the northern plains. And there are three rivers of the Central Highlands, Chambal, Son and Betwa, which join them. Now the Narmada and Tapi rivers begin in the Vindhya Ranges and flow westwards. Let's move further children. The Deccan Plateau. The Deccan Plateau lies to the south of the Satpura Ranges and stretches up to the southern tip of the Indian Peninsula. Children, if you remember, I asked you what is the meaning of the word Peninsular India, right? So you all told me that peninsula is a part of land which is covered from three sides of water, which is covered through water from the three sides. All right. Now let's move further and let's read the second point. The Deccan Plateau is surrounded by the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats. Okay. These Ghats meet at the Nilgiri Hills. The Western Ghats are a chain of hills that run parallel to the west coast of India. All of this, children, we have done and covered in the northern and the coastal plains. Now, children, this is a very important fact of the Deccan Plateau, that Anai Muri is the highest peak of this region. Okay, let's move further. Now, children, you have to do this small exercise. You have to identify the following minerals found in the Southern Plateau. Come on, just guess. I know we have already done this activity in the live class and you all answered it very correctly. So double thumbs up from my side to you. So children, the first mineral is the coal. Very good. The second one is the iron. The third is petroleum. Number fourth in the picture, you can see copper wires. Number fifth is manganese. Now, children, please don't forget these minerals, because minerals play a very important role in the Southern Plateau region. Okay, you have to understand that mining is a very important activity because of the availability of the minerals, these minerals in the plateau region, in the Southern Plateau region. Now, some interesting facts to know. The Godavari is the longest river in the Deccan Plateau. A plateau is also called a table land. Madhya Pradesh is the largest producer of soya bean in the country. This is an extra fact, children. Okay, your mama must be making soya beans, right? It's a very healthy food. Now, mining is an important activity in the Southern Plateaus. When a river, now children, let's discuss the waterfall. Okay, let us discuss the definition of the waterfall. It is given on page number 38 of your book. All right, it says when a river or a stream falls from the edge of a mountain or a plateau, it forms a waterfall. And the Jog Falls in Karnataka is a very famous waterfall. Now, children, I would also like to tell you that along with Godavari River, which is the longest river in the Deccan Plateau, we have two more rivers, those are Krishna and Kaveri. So three rivers, that are Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri, originate from the Western Ghats and flow eastwards. All of this we have done in the map, we have marked in the map, which is given on page number 38, map 5.1, location of the Southern Plateau and islands. Okay, so please learn these interesting facts. Thank you, children. I would like to see you very soon. This was video number 1 of concept number 1.